So first example is we want to prove that these two triangles are congruent. First off, let's figure out which triangles we're talking about, so let's name them. Now, as you remember from other videos, naming triangles in order to prove that they're congruent is an important thing. It's important to keep the order correct. So let's take a look at this triangle on the left. Maybe we could start at angle T here. If we follow T and kind of head in the direction of I, end up at C. So we could say triangle TIC. Well, what is angle T, this angle up top here, what does that correspond with? Well, in this other triangle off to the right, that angle is made up of the shared side and also the segment with one congruence mark. So the angle that shares one congruence mark and fits the shared side is this angle. So we'll begin naming our second triangle with C. In triangle TIC, we follow T towards I, end up at C. In other words, we go down the segment with one tick mark and follow the segment with two tick marks. In the green triangle, the one off to the right, we're going to follow one tick mark, head towards these second congruence tick marks. So triangle C is where we'll start, head toward A, end up at T. Can't spell apparently. C-A-T. So we want to prove that triangles C-A-T and T-I-C are congruent. How are we going to do that? Well, let's take a look at those congruence marks again. I see I've got one pair of segments. Let's call this I-C. I-C and A-T must be congruent because they both have these two pairs of congruence marks on them. And likewise, this segment TI is going to be congruent to segment AC. And then finally, just from the way that these two triangles are drawn, we've got a shared side up the middle. And so what that means is I've got the green pair of sides, I've got the blue shared side up the middle, and I've got the red pair of shared sides. So we're going to prove that these two triangles are congruent using side, side, side. So let's get to it. So first off, remember we were trying to prove that triangle TIC was congruent with triangle CAT. We were given the two green sides are congruent, so that's TI and CA. And then also we have the two red sides are congruent. So we've got what we have given, we have what we're trying to prove. Now let's start filling in our three boxes. In the previous slide, we established that we are going to use the side-side-side congruence theorem for this proof. So we can fill that in as the reason right now. Let's see. If and so in order to prove that these two triangles are congruent, well, first off, we should name them. We wanted to prove that triangle TIC was congruent to triangle CAT. In order to do that, we need to first prove that we've got a pair of sides, another pair of sides, and a final pair of sides that are congruent. The reason we need to do that is in this triangle congruence theorem, we have the if part of the sentence, the hypothesis, and that must be satisfied in order for the then, the conclusion, to be true. So which pair of sides do we have? I know AT is congruent to IC, and the reason that I know that to be true is that's given information. Likewise, the green segments, segment TI and CA, are congruent for the same reasons. We've got given information. And then lastly, we need to talk about the shared side. So that shared side is kind of strange. In triangle TIC, I see that the segment is, if we follow the order of the letters, then the segment would be called TC. However, the corresponding segments in triangle CAT would be, instead of TC, it would actually be CT. And that follows from the order of the letters in the names of the triangles. So we have that shared side, and we need to talk about the fact that that shared side gives us congruent segments. So TC is shared by both triangles, and as a result, it must be congruent in both triangles. And the statement that we use is called the reflexive property of equality. And now we're done. Each of our different puzzle pieces has fallen into place. We've proven what it is we're trying to prove, and now we're good to go. Proof number one, done.